So have you ever felt the need to take a dump when you go to the bookstore? Well, if so, you are not alone. In this video today, we will talk about what is called the Mariko Aoki phenomenon, what this is, why does this occur, what is the deal with bookstores and taking a dump, and could this happen to you? Guys, let's literally talk about poop and a bookstore. Howdy y'all, Dr. Samir here, aka your poop guru, trying to give you the best tips and tricks to help out with your health. If you haven't already, don't forget to smash that like button, like, share, and subscribe. And if you haven't already, don't forget to subscribe to weekly newsletter where you can get great tips and tricks like you're learning in this video. So I was, browsing the internet and all that stuff, looking for topics. I saw this phenomenon called the Mariko Aoki phenomenon. Legend has it that in the mid-1980s, a woman named Mariko Aoki from Japan wrote a letter confessing that she felt the urge to take a dump as soon as she entered a bookstore. Say what? Yes. As soon as she went to the bookstore, she had to take a poop. But many others wrote afterwards saying they had the exact same problem. So this is a real condition. Absolutely it is. I've heard about this. I've even had patients come to me for this particular condition. It is the sudden urge to use the restroom as soon as you enter a bookstore. It's also known as book bowels, a name that I love myself. And a lot of people think about it in these terms as well. So what exactly is going on? There are some theories that the smell of the book or ink can really trigger a Pavlovian response in which all of a sudden you feel the urge to poop. Or maybe that book paper has a laxative effect. Or maybe the fact that all that knowledge, all that information gets people overwhelmed and all of a sudden they have to take a dump. Well, we know for sure this is a purely psychological phenomenon. Now, when I say that, I'm not saying these people are crazy at all, but we do know there is a connection between the brain and the gut. It's called the brain-gut axis. So it happens right here, will manifest right here, and same thing vice versa as well. So a lot of my patients who are nervous, have anxiety, depression, they can feel symptoms of GERD, heartburn, diarrhea and constipation, and that can make their anxiety and depression worse, and it's being a very vicious cycle. And this is exactly what's going on in this condition as well. There's something that triggers a nervousness, a tension, just maybe a lot of anxiety of being in a quiet area and knowing that you're walking around, or all those books that are everywhere with all this knowledge, all this information, can trigger a connection between the brain and the gut to make you use the restroom and have the urge to go. We see this very commonly in conditions like irritable bowel syndrome, or diarrhea, or even Crohn's disease or colitis as well. Whereas there's some sort of trigger that occurs right here will cause you to have gut issues. And the same thing happens when you have butterflies in your stomach. I have a video on this which explains this in more detail. But that nervousness that you feel whenever you have to give a speech can manifest as these butterflies that you're feeling inside your GI tract. And this may not be limited to bookstores also. Some people have this urge when they go to a park or go to a museum, places that are quiet, peaceful, or places that have a lot of knowledge or information that's there, the same type of trigger that occurs that causes you to have to use the restroom more frequently and more often as well. The other issue could be that when you go to a bookstore, go to a museum, or maybe go to a park, you're also wondering, I wonder where the nearest restroom is. You get a lot of anxiety from that. There are so many patients who have gut issues, diarrhea and constipation specifically, even Crohn's or colitis, that the first thing they do when they go to an area is scope out where the bathroom is. The bathroom is right there. I know I need to head that way if I need to use the restroom or if I have the urge to go. And so whenever you enter maybe a park or museum, you're wondering, oh my goodness, where is the nearest bathroom? And that can trigger that desire or that urge to use a restroom right then and there. And lastly, there is this theory that if you hunch over when you're trying to read a book, that angle will cause you to actually use the restroom more often. There is some evidence for that. Position plays a huge role when it comes to pooping, constipation, and diarrhea. This is why things like a squatty potty work very, very well. It changes the angle between the rectum and the bottom to make it a lot more of a slide to allow things to pass through. And when you're leaning forward, trying to read a book, that change in posture can change that angle and make you more likely to feel the need to use the restroom. But this actually is a real phenomenon. It's not made up. There are a lot of people around the world who suffer from this condition. So my question today for you guys, do you know somebody who's like this, who has this condition, or is there another condition you've heard about that you want me to speak about? Comment down below. I would love to hear what you guys have to say. I want to thank you for watching. Don't forget to smash that like button, like, share, and subscribe. And if you haven't already, don't forget to subscribe to a weekly newsletter where you can get great tips and tricks like you're learning in this video. Guys, let's talk about poop. Thank you.